fan of Huey Lewis in the News?
Sure I am.
I am too.
I see you got that hip radio set back there.
I do.
Let's listen.
All right. Now, back when they first released their first album, I thought it was a little too hip for my liking.
Makes sense.
So, I ignored them for a little bit. But now, after some time, they learned their virtues, and they made lots of better music. Now, I can listen to them and really appreciate their taste.
To the Bryans, nice to meet you. Apart from the Matthews.
Detective Matthews.
Call the camera guy.
Matthews, what are we looking at here?
So it looks like, based on the police reports that were given to us by the responding officers, it appears that the victim was watching something, TV, and it appears that from over there, the assailant came downstairs, had the axe, killed the young adult, and left the axe and appears to have fled the scene.
Matthew, is there any suspects for this case?
Yeah, we have two potential suspects. One is his ex-girlfriend, Sarah Smith, and she talked about how they went out that night, gave some information, and she was suspicious of her boyfriend's friend, Richard Dickinson, who had some arguments with his coworker. And now he's dead, so we believe that he may be a suspect, but we don't know where he is.
I'll call the coroner. I got the report from the coroner.
As predicted, he was drunk. And, you know, axe to the head, it's a pretty clear-cut case. The trouble is, we're going to have to find the suspect. But other than that, we have a lot of good things that we found.
Motherfucker,
you can't prove shit! And you can't prove it! You know you.
Holy
shit! You can't prove it! You can't prove shit!
This is the axe we found on the floor at the scene. Test positive for Richard's fingerprints and Steven's blood on the top.
Without a shadow of a doubt, that's the case?
100%.
Alright, looks like we got him. Let's go talk to him.
Let's get him.
Yeah, I'll be here. You go get him. You have the right to remain silent. Anything you say and will be used against you in a court of law. You have the right to an attorney. If you cannot afford an attorney, one will be provided to you by the state. If you decide to answer questions now without an attorney present, you will still have the right to stop answering any of these questions anytime until you talk to an attorney. Do you understand the rights I've just read to you? With these in mind, do you wish to speak with us?
Yes.
Sign the waiver here. Your Miranda rights. All right, Dick. Why did you kill Steven?
You got no evidence.
We have no evidence?
Nope. Not one.
We have the axe. We have the prints on the axe. They match to yours, to central booking. So it's very clear cut right there.
No, it's not.
Of his ex-girlfriend.
That bitch. I hate that bitch.
Where were you last night, huh?
I was at the bars.
With who?
With Stevens and with Sarah. You have no proof, though. What do you...
We have proof. We have the testimony from Sarah. Your fingerprints are on
the axe. No, they're not!
Yes, they are.
No, they're not.
Yes?
No, they're not.
We have the fingerprints from the radio you clicked to play Huey Lewis.
Was it worth it?
Why? Why did you do it?
They're getting out.
We knew you had troubles. We don't have to. We can make a deal with you. Look, if you confess right now to this murder, you will have an easy time in prison.
I don't want to go to jail, man. I can't go to jail. I can't go back.
Look, your future is prison. It's whether or not how long you want to be there.
I can't go back to jail. I can't.
Look, you don't understand. You don't understand.
I think you very well understand the situation here.
No.
Anything to say?
No. Where's Rick?
Let me tell you something.
No!
Let me tell you something.
Where's
You're going
Rick?
To prison.
Where's Rick?
If you confess, you might even get probation.
Nope. Where's Rick?
Who's Rick? Who's Rick?
Where's Rick?
Who's Rick?
Where's Rick?
Look, man, we're here to help you. We're here to give you a fair...
You don't have proof!
We do have proof. We have the axe.
But I can't go back to jail, you know?
Hey, that's not for you to decide anymore. Maybe you shouldn't have killed him.
I didn't kill anybody, though.
So where were you last night?
I was with Steven.
You were with Stevens?
Yeah.
Where?
At the bars.
Where after that?
I went home.
Uh-huh. So on your way home, you just put your fingerprints all over his basement?
No. No, I didn't.
Uh-huh.
Matthews, what are you thinking here?
You know, this guy loves perjuring himself.
No, it's Sarah's fault. It's Sarah's fault. She did this. She broke up with me!
Sarah?
Yes!
She broke up with you, but she was dating Stevens.
He had it coming!
Oh, he had it coming. Is that a confession?
He asked for it. He hurt her. He hurt her. I didn't do this. He did it.
Uh-huh.
He did it to himself.
So who killed Stevens?
Look, I did it, but it's not my fault. It's his fault.
Okay.
He put the axe in my hands.
Why,
he did it.
Why is it your fault?
It's his fault.
Sorry.
You're not listening.
Why is it his
fault? It's his fault, not my fault.
Why is it his fault?
Because he did this. She broke up with him and he yelled at her.
Uh-huh. That seems kind of out of range.
I need my lawyer. I need Saul. I need to call Saul.
So
I need to call Saul.
You're requesting counsel.
I'm requesting my lawyer, Saul Goodman. I need him now.
That's when we leave. All right.
You're not going to win. I got the best lawyer in the county. You can't.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Tonight we have a very sad story for you. Local man Stephen Brown, worker at Dunder Mifflin as an accountant, was murdered late last night at 11:27 p.m. in his own home. After a long night at the bar with his friends, he would come home with his good friend, Richard Dickinson, to a couple of drinks and to watch some TV. After a couple hours, he would then be murdered by his close friend. Richard Dickinson was caught early the next morning outside of Stephen's home, presumably to return to the crime scene and clear up his trace. After being caught at the crime scene, he was taken into police custody and was interrogated by the two lead detectives, Detective Matthews and Ryans. Later in the investigation, they would gain a full confession out of Richard Dickinson. After that point on, they would then interrogate more and look around just to see if maybe he was just insane and he didn't do anything, but that was not true. Richard Dickinson was proven dead to rights to have killed young Stephen Brown.
Bob Clippy Legs.